That's your channel.
This is Yano.
And this is Jackie.
Today we're going to talk about our 5 favorite photographs we've ever taken.
We both have enjoyed photography for a few years now. Over the few years that we've taken pictures, I think I've had some pretty decent ones, or some that I'm actually like proud of. So yeah, we just want to discuss them with you and show them to you and see what you think. Like, if you know anything about photography, let us know. And if you have any feedback on how we can be better or something, like, yeah, like, for sure, we appreciate the feedback.
So we're gonna be sharing our top 5. So we're gonna do nature, we're gonna do night, we're gonna do child, and we're gonna do portrait, and then animals.
I don't really have one for the animal. I'm gonna switch it for a newborn picture that I took.
I've been doing photography for probably 4 years, 5 years. I started 2016. I do think it was 2016 when I started. And ever since I got my first camera, it was really like a Kodak kind of camera. Super basic camera. I fell in love with it. Like, I just love taking pictures of anything I could like think of or see. I just like taking pictures. So that's like my background with photography and why I love it. I'm still learning a lot. I don't know, I just like taking pictures overall. My favorite nature picture overall right now that I've taken was in San Antonio at the Japanese garden. Super pretty with my new lens that I got. I was using my camera, the Canon Rebel T6. My favorite overall image that I've taken is a flower. I don't know, I just took it. I really didn't think much of it. I was like, oh, I'm gonna just take a picture of a flower, and I did. And then when I finally ported them to my phone, I like how blurry the background was and how super good quality the image looked. So I think that's why it's one of my favorite nature photos.
It's one of those things that when you nail the focus and
yeah,
you have a really nice bokeh, like,
yeah, in the background,
it just kind of works.
Yeah. Yes. So to me, that image looks super high quality, so it would definitely be one of my favorite nature photos at the moment.
My favorite nature photography I've ever taken, it's gonna be this one right here. I invited a friend to go to the beach and during sunrise hours so that we could like catch the sun coming up and everything, and it was actually pretty fun. I had just gotten my Nikon L840, which is a point and shoot, but it has like really amazing zoom. So I remember I was just there, you know, messing with my camera, and then I focused on the sun, and when I focused on the sun, the screen just went red. And this picture is not edited, it's literally just how I came out, and I loved it. Yeah. I thought it was like,
it's
so good. Yes.
It's like perfect kind of moment. When did you start photography, or like, do you remember when you started photography?
Oh, I started, I think about the same time as you did, maybe 2015, 2016.
For me, I know the first time I started taking pictures of people was in Easter, around Easter in the park. I still have the picture, it's of my sister. The very first time that I can remember that I started taking pictures. And that from that point on, I was like, you know what, I like this, I'm gonna continue it.
Yeah.
And I started taking pictures of like my cousins and my sisters. So that's how it all started, you know?
Yeah.
And that's how I started practicing and really getting into it.
I used to work at a store and I saw the camera, which the LA40 is a red camera, and so it looked really pretty. I didn't have a camera or anything like that. I didn't know anything about it. I didn't know even if I was gonna use it or not. So I liked it, and I mean, it was a little pricey. It was like, I don't know, maybe $200, something like that. So I was like, yo, you know what, I'm gonna buy it, I really like it. And that's how I kind of like started like seeing it. And at first I remember I was just like, oh, okay, like, yeah, I have a camera, whatever, you know. And then I started like googling pictures taken with that camera, and I started seeing a bunch of good ones, and I was like, so I can do this too, you know. And then I remember seeing one of the moon, and I did try one of the moon, and I mean, it was pretty decent. It's not the greatest, but it was pretty decent. That's how it kind of started. And I invited my friend Michelle, who she also loves photography, if she wanted to come and take pictures with me, and she agreed, and we just went, and that's how my first picture came to life.
Yeah. The second photo that we chose was night photography. For me, I chose a picture of the moon. I really liked the way it captured the moon that night. It looked super pretty. I'm still learning a lot about night photography because it's really challenging. You just really know how to like set your camera. You really need to know the perfect timing of when you're taking your image. It's always best to use a tripod because you're probably gonna have to like really pick up the exposure. Like your aperture is gonna be like, it could be blurry if you're holding it. That's what I'm saying.
For my night photography, I chose this one right here. This was actually my second attempt at star photography, night photography. I had gone out previously one time. I couldn't get the focus right. Like, I just couldn't. I had the tripod, you know, and I had everything. I just couldn't get the freaking focus down. After that first attempt, I went back home. I researched a bunch. I was like, okay, I got it. And then I went back out there. I finally was able to get it. And it's not perfect. And, you know, there's obviously a lot better images in this one. But I was really proud of it. I was able to focus. I was able to get a little bit of the Milky Way in there. And I don't know, it was just a really proud moment.
I feel like that's how we are as like photographers. We get super excited when we capture like the perfect moment and like,
yes,
super good.
Even if it's not like the best picture out there, but like it's like the best picture that we took personally. You know?
The next category, we're gonna talk about child portraits. Mm-hmm. I chose this little girl I've been taking pictures of since she was like a newborn. It was Easter and that day was super windy. So I remember posing her against the fan. I just told her, I mean, obviously it's really hard to work with kids, really hard. You need to try your best to like have them stay there and keep them distracted. Like when you're taking them pictures, try to make them laugh, have their mom behind you and like calling them so that they can look at the camera and like look at you. So I feel like I have a really good chemistry with this little girl because I've been taking pictures of her since she was a baby. So she already recognizes me when I take her photos. So she knows who I am. So I feel like that's like a big help for me. So this picture that I chose, I decided to put it black and white because, I don't know, it just makes it look better in my opinion. I like the face expression she made. I like the hair on her face. Like the perfect timing of that, you know, 1 second I just pressed the button and I just got that image.
Her expression was really nice. I like that one. So my favorite picture that I've ever taken of a child is gonna be when I took of my nephew. He's a crazy kid. Crazy kid. He's not gonna like stay there and pose. This kid was playing with the ball and I was just snapping pictures like.
But those are always
up
the best,
and
right?
Yes.
Like now that we're more experienced, I feel like those are always the best. Like the most unexpected pictures.
I could not choose my favorite one from this shoot. Like I just couldn't. I even had to take him out by myself because like my sister always like, well, we both procrastinate, but she would tell me like, hey, I want to take a picture for the baby for his 2-year-old party. And I was like, oh, okay. And we kept putting it off. And the party was going to be like the next weekend. So we needed to do it already. My sister was going to go to work and then I was going to be working. So I was like, you know what, just dress him and I'll take him. And I took him just to like, literally across from my house there's an empty lot and I was like, okay, I'm just gonna take him there. And I took a ball and I was throwing it at him and he just like comes out and poses like I was just like, oh my god, yes, thank you so much.
I think it's such a pretty picture because of the way he's like normally like doing his thing. Mm-hmm. And then when she captured his image, like I think it's like a perfect moment. And it looks super good.
Yeah,
so
I also love it that ever since that day he'll just see my DSLR camera come out and he'll be like, picture.
Same
thing. I'm like, oh,
same
okay.
Thing with my niece. Same thing with my niece too. It's funny. The fourth category we chose was portraits. I chose my friend. She was down that day to go take a photo. That time I was really getting into really like taking more serious with portraits. So that day we wanted to go to the beach. We decided to take pictures in her prom dress, which she was totally fine with. I really liked this image because I just like the colors in the image. I like the way she's centered. I like the waves naturally, how they're like, you know, capturing the image.
And I think you kind of nailed the focus on that one, like
on her.
Yes.
Yeah, and that's always my goal. I always like pictures for portraits. I mean, to look like not blurry on their face and stuff like that. I like for it to be super HD, pretty much, right? Mm-hmm. That time when I went to the beach with her, I was so nervous because it was probably like one of my first times ever taking like portraits of her. It was fun too because I got to learn some stuff that I could like fix.
For me, my favorite portrait I've ever taken is gonna be this one right here. This image, I love it so much. Since I took it, like the moment I took it, I fell in love with it. I loved her expression, the way she's posing her hands. She's not family, she's like a family friend. I told her like, hey, let's go take pictures. And she's like, yeah, sure, you know? And like, it just worked. I liked her outfit, I liked her makeup, and she was so good. I don't know, I just really loved it. The way she's positioned, the way she's looking out, for me, it just screams like, God, just help me. Like, I know you got me, you know? I don't know, like, that's what it spoke to me.
Yeah, it's such a pretty picture.
Yeah, it's really pretty, like, the way you framed it. I like the framing of it. And instead of going portrait mode, you did, like, the landscape, yeah. And it's perfect.
The last category that we chose was animals. This picture that I selected, I actually took it not that long ago. And my trip with my family, it was just that kind of moment where I was in the car, we were driving, and I saw a deer. And I was like, okay, stop, you have to stop. And there was cars. And I was like, just pull over, I want to, like, take some pictures. And I had my camera, which was, like, perfect. I remember being in the car and rolling down the window. They were passing, actually, in front of us. I was like, oh, this is perfect, like, super perfect. And I just remember getting my camera and just taking pictures of the deer.
For me, the last one I chose wasn't an animal category. I chose to switch it for a newborn category because I didn't have an animal. The picture I chose was the first time I ever saw anybody deliver a baby. My friend allowed me to come and I was like, hey, you know, can I take some pictures? Like, would you be okay? And she was like, yeah, sure, I don't mind. But there was another picture that I chose, which was my favorite, but I thought that was more intimate. So my second favorite was this one. And I don't know, I loved it that I kind of like, I got the focus right and the colors look good and the baby's just crying and yeah, I don't know, I loved it.
Yeah. I just like that, like, you know, her capturing that moment, it's like a big memory for the parents and stuff.
Yes.
That's a good thing, you know, with photography, mm-hmm. that you just capture moments and you mm-hmm. give it to the families.
And they stay there forever.
Yeah.
So. Well, not forever. Yeah, for a long time.
Forever. But yeah, this was our top five favorite photographs that we've taken throughout all our, like, since we started. If you have any questions, has to do with photography or anything else, comment below and let us know.
Yeah, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel if you enjoy our content. We would appreciate it so much. We'll see you on the next one. Thank you. Bye.